Hello and welcome to Sadir Sadas. We said we'll show you different shades of being a Sadir artist, particularly at Ranga Mandira. We've been showing you some interesting shades, but today I think I'm going to share with you a very personal and a very, very interesting and completely like mind-boggling shade. A Sadir artist who discovers a completely different version of dance history. That's the shade. Okay, why do I say that? Now, as dancers and as common people, we would have all heard how Bharatanatyam, all classical dances, but Bharatanatyam particularly, is connected to the cosmic dancer. Who is the cosmic dancer? Lord Shiva. You're right. So, Lord Shiva is considered to be the cosmic dancer, and some people say he's the originator, the first dancer, the primordial dancer, etc., etc. Now, we all buy into this story. You see, we are in Navratri time, right? So, in Navratri, the thing that we do is keep a lot of dolls and we tell stories. These stories help us say the same thing over and over again through generations and allows us to believe many a times that these stories are real. We don't question these stories. But as a Sadir artist, when I got an opportunity to question one such story, I was blown away by the answer I got. I'll tell you what happened. So, we always think that Lord Shiva is the cosmic dancer. But what if I told you that Lord Muruga, who is considered a Tamil Kadavul, Tamil Devam, Murugan is supposed to be a god of beauty, a god of splendor, the god of the Tamils, that he too was a cosmic dancer. Will you allow it? Will you accept it? Will you believe it?
Muruga va va kanda va va ennai ka va velava shanmuga va va kanda
I'm not just saying this because I'm Tamil, or I'm not just saying this because I want to say something different. After several years of research, I was blown away by what I really discovered and understood. So you know Kumbakonam. Kumbakonam is down south. And in Kumbakonam, there's a temple called Sharangapani Temple. When I went to that temple years ago, almost a decade ago, I saw the Karana panels that were there, and I was studying Karanas anyway, both under Dr. Padma Subramanian, but I was also studying them little more detailed towards my own research in the Nayaka period, because in the Nayaka era, we were, Sadir was already incorporating a lot of Karanas. So in studying this, I came across some very interesting information. Muruga has another name. His name is Guha, right? He is the Lord. That is, he is the master of dwarfs, little dwarfs who are all dancers and who are sort of roguish, who are short and stout and give a lot of like trouble to people who come near them. And those little ones are called Guhyas. So Muruga is the lord of Guhyas, therefore he is Guha, right? And Muruga is also supposed to be the god of the hills, mountains. So even today you will see that the Kuratis and the Kuravanjis are all on the Tamil god Murugan, and he's supposed to be on Kundru, that is on a hillock or on a mountain top. Right? This is there from Sangam period onwards. Now, in fact, I can take you back and share with you another beautiful example of why he is on the hill. Right? So Namalodi Silapadigaratla, which is one of the five Tamil epics, there is something called Kundra Kuravai. That is, Kuravai is group dance, and Kundru, the one for the one who's living or residing on the hill. Seergalu sendilum sengodum venkundrum.
Seergalu sendilum sengodum venkundrum. Yeragamum neenga.
So there are several legends that tell you that Muruga is one of the gods who resides on a mountain.
Kandava,
Now this Muruga is living on a mountain, and his co-residents or his friends or his juniors are all these guhyas who are all dwarfs who play around and be a little roguish on the mountain. Now this group of guhyas and their head or leader Guha are supposed to be young adolescent boys, because Muruga is also a young adolescent boy. In all his stories, including in Parni, he's known to be an adolescent lad. What he does in adolescence is he teases young girls who come to pray to the temple. He's teasing. So what happens? People over time, they tell you that please, young girls who've just come of age, you know, don't go alone to a hill temple of Muruga. So even now in the north, if you go, they'll say that you can't, a young unmarried woman can't go to a Kartikeya temple on a hill alone. Now, where do all these stories come from? It comes from the fact that we imagine Muruga to be this adolescent lad along with his guhyas who will be a little roguish. He will come and play with these girls, and therefore these girls will get a little... Imagine, you know, imagine Lord Muruga coming and playing with you. So you'll be a little shaken, and so, you know, oru madri veri vanda madri agino. Adanala vandu konju pei pattam pidicha mari aidum. Adanala thani anpadinga ponnungala appdin solluvanga. Yo, idu vandu oru legend. Ana, this idea of guhya and guha, especially fond of women in ranajani, or women who are hormonal, right? Because, you know, your blood is smelling differently, your hormones are raging. Now, I wrote an entire paper on this. I presented a lecture. It's all there on YouTube. If you go to my channel, Swarnamalya channel on YouTube, there are lectures after lectures where I've spoken about these things, and I've written, and you know, it's a very interesting topic. You'd love to hear it, if, you know, if you're interested in those kinds of things. But the story is, because Murugan vandu ipdi oru devam, avan vandu ipdi irukkaradunala, avanu oru dancer. Ena avan eppadi jolly-a irukkirathu, dance adi thane. ஸோ இந்த முருகனுங்கிற அந்த ஆடல் கடவுள் அப்படி நம்ம அவனை பார்த்ததே இல்லை. அவனை வந்து தமிழ் கடவுளாக மட்டும்தான் பார்க்குறோம். ஆனால் அவன் தான் ஆடலுக்கும் முழுமுதற் கடவுள். சேயோன் இஸ் சிவன். இந்த மாதிரி நீங்கள் ஒரு ரிசர்ச் கேள்விப்பட்டீங்களா? என்னுடைய மை டீச்சர் ஃபார் ஆர்கியாலஜி அண்ட் எபிக்ரஃபி டாக்டர் ராமச்சந்திரன், ஹீ ஹெல்ப்ட் மீ ரியலி அன்டை திஸ் என்டயர் ரிசர்ச். அண்ட் ஸோ ஐ வாஸ் ப்ளோன் அவே வித் த ஃபேக்ட் தட் Guha can also be a cosmic dancer. And believe it or not, in Tanjavur Saraswati Mahal library, I found a manuscript called Guhesa Bharata Lakshanam. Now this Guhesa Bharata Lakshanam can actually be seen as Guhya Kesa Bharata Lakshanam. So an entire school of dance based on Muruga as the cosmic dancer is out there. And as a Sadir dancer, as a researcher, as a dance history student, my mind was like blown away. So every time I now dance for Muruga, I think of him as the god of dance. Murugana namba vandu tamil kadavul mattum nenikrom, but avar tamil kadavul mattum illa, aadarukku mulumudar kadavul. So for Sadir, I really think it's very, very beautiful to celebrate this version of a cosmic dancer as well. And that's what we've been precisely doing at Ranga Mandira. So many stories and so many narratives and so many histories have been turned on their heads for us. And for me, that has been the most exhilarating journey. I hope you enjoyed listening to this. See you in another episode. சதிர் நடனமும் கர்நாடக இசையும் எங்ககிட்ட கத்துக்கணும்னு நீங்க ஆசைப்பட்டீங்கன்னா உங்களுடைய பேரு, ஏஜ், உங்களுடைய இமெயில் ஐடி, உங்களுடைய முகவரி, ஃபோன் நம்பர் இதெல்லாம் வச்சு எங்களுக்கு ஒரு இமெயில் அனுப்புங்க, இல்லை வாட்ஸ்அப் அனுப்புங்க, இல்லை ஃபோன் கூட பண்ணி பேசலாம். எல்லா டீட்டெயில்ஸும் டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் பாக்ஸில் இருக்குது. நீங்கள் பிகினராக இருக்கலாம், இல்லை கொஞ்சம் வருஷம் கற்றுக்கிட்டவங்களாக இருக்கலாம், இல்லை சீனியர் ஆர்டிஸ்டாக கூட இருக்கலாம், எல்லாருக்குமே இந்த சதிர் நடனத்தில் ஏதோ ஒன்று இருக்குது. Please do like, share and subscribe to our channel and follow us on all our social media handles so that you can be part of and keep up with all the exciting stuff that we are doing.